We are so excited to have him in the studio. Please make some noise for Stormzy. Hey.
What's happening, guys?
He's back.
I'm back.
How are you, man?
I'm all right. How are you guys?
I feel like we haven't seen you in a minute. When was the last time we saw Stormzy?
Was it post-Glastonbury?
We saw you at Haunted House Party.
Yeah, Haunted House Party.
Yeah, that's
but
true.
Also, that would have been pre-Vossi Bop.
No, that was after Vossi Bop.
So pre-Glasto, after Vossi.
Yeah.
Whenever that was.
Somewhere in between. And I remember the last time you were in, we were talking about the album.
Yeah.
And you were in album mode.
Yeah.
As you said it yourself. You must be happy that this is out now, because I feel like you were on this for a long time.
Yeah, it's like, I always say making music's a very crazy thing, because you go away for about... Well, it could be some people it's a year, some people it's 2 years, some people it's 3-4 years. So you go away, you're in studio, and you're absolutely like working relentlessly, and then you put it out into the world, and that's it.
There you go.
That's
yeah,
it.
And then obviously when you're in studio, you'd like to think you're absolutely murking, and then that's what you're in there, but then you don't know. You know what I mean? And then it goes out into the world, but I do know.
Yeah. You know it's good.
Yeah.
I've heard it took a lot longer than management would have wanted.
Yeah, it took longer than everyone would have wanted. Yeah, but I always say the way I approach music is a very, very, it's very meticulous. I take it very seriously. I treat it like art. So
yeah.
Mm-hmm. But whatever time it takes, that's how long I'm gonna take.
You're going head to head with Harry Styles.
Ah, yeah. The boy Harry, yeah.
And he came on the show, and we were chatting to him, and apparently he'd happily set up a fight between you and him.
Yeah, I heard that. You know, I'm not sure I'd want that.
Are
though,
you down
man.
For this or not?
Nah,
no.
Man. Do you know Harry seems like a scrapper. Yeah.
He goes for the legs.
Yeah, he seems like he's a bit difficult to like. He seems quick and just like a scrapper. Like, and I'm a bit slow.
I reckon he's a whirling dervish guy.
Do you reckon?
Whereas I reckon you're...
No, I reckon he's just a bit of a mad little, you know what I mean? Like a mad little fish. Like. You know, just like, before I know it, I'm just wrapped up. Like, I don't think I want that, personally.
No battling Harry anytime soon.
Nah. I don't want no smoke with Harry.
What about Harry Styles' diss track?
Oh.
My boy,
I don't know, man. He would have to start it.
Yeah.
And then I'll have to end it.
Oh, my God.
That was dark, innit?
Big.
Oh, mate.
I would love. Who did Eminem have a beef with? He had a beef with that guy.
He's had a few.
Who?
Machine Gun Kelly.
Yes, Machine Gun Kelly and Eminem had a thing. I'd love it if it was
Harry Styles.
That would be way better than Eminem versus Machine Gun Kelly.
Yeah.
That would be way more epic. It would be like, whoa. It would be like McGregor Mayweather.
Oh!
Two different worlds, you know what I mean? UFC boxing, rap versus Harry Styles.
But what do you even rhyme with Styles? Harry Styles.
Harry Styles. He's got a really nice smile. Yeah. That's not really a diss, though, is it?
But I'm feeling wild.
But I'm feeling, Harry Styles, you got a really nice smile, but do you know what? I don't really care because I'm feeling wild. Done him. Finished him. You think I'll be better at it? Harry.
My man.
You're done, mate. You're finished.
He's coming for him. Well, listen, Ed's returning the favour, collaborating on your album now. Have you been to Ed's house? Because I feel like anyone that's friends with Ed, what is going on in this manor that he's building?
Oh, mate. It's like Disneyland.
Tell me.
Disneyland.
We hear he's got
planning
permission for all different things going on there.
He's got everything. Ed's just... Do you know what it is with Ed? Once you know Ed, there's an Ed style to like many things. Mm. As in, there's things that I hear that he's done and I'm like, very Ed.
Only he could do that.
Very Ed.
Typical Ed.
Like, so his house is incredible. His house, mate, I went to his house and I got back to my house and I just looked at it and thought,
what's going on?
It's this manger. Like, I was thinking, the hell is his face? Like, but yeah, his house is epic. Like he's got
so you drive in.
You kind of get buzzed in, and then a guy comes out, and you know what I mean? It's all very FBI. And then you go in, and then it's just Disneyland. That's what it feels like. I swear to you, it feels like Disneyland. He's got a lake, or a pond, or a
thing.
Ocean, I don't know what it is. And then he's got the cinema room, he's got a pub as well.
I know.
But it's a pub. It's not like a...
It's not fake.
It's like Queen Vic pub.
Yes, it's a pub as in you could it's a pub.
You could trade from this pub.
Yes, you could. Yeah. Like it doesn't feel like a kind of like. Like a mini, it's not a mini pub, it's an actual big pub.
Yeah,
it's a pub.
It's called
you don't
Cherry,
know, it's a pub. Yeah, pardon?
It's called after his wife, isn't it? It's called Cherry, I think.
Is it? I know. Yeah, it's one of those names, but it's like, it's again, very Ed. It's like a clever name.
Yeah.
It's like a clever pub name.
It's
like,
typical
it's
Ed.
Like, yeah, it's the something named after the something, which means something to Ed.
Right.
Very sentimental.
Sounds like it.
Yeah, sounds like it.
God, he's
yeah.
clever, isn't he?
He's a clever one, isn't he?
You had a portrait of yourself hung in the National Portrait Gallery.
Yes.
You're doing up Mona Lisa.
Yeah, a bit, yeah.
What's going on with this?
I don't know. Boy, I guess I'm... thank God I'm now someone, you know, getting up in the world, you know, so...
It's sick.
Yeah, no, it's very sick. Do you know what was really good?
Mm.
This is a bit deep as well, yeah? But there was loads of... Like, walking through the thing... Like, of course, there's loads of legendary people and incredible people, but you can tell, because it's like from like the 1500s, and I was thinking, a lot of these guys are probably racist, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
true.
Back then, and like, you when you read the thing, a lot of them was like colonial and all of these crazy words and that. And I was thinking, look at this, they're probably turning in their grave. Like,
there you are.
Yeah.
Look at him. Look at that. Look at that black guy. There we go. It was an honour to be up there. So, yeah, thank you to the National Portrait Gallery as well.
Good. Officially
we
stuck it to the man.
Yeah,
we love
officially,
that.
Officially, yeah, yeah. And it felt necessary. It felt important. It felt like they called it contemporary intervention.
Mm.
Bet they did.
Yeah.
Very nice.
I mean, what does that mean?
I don't know. Sounds epic as hell.
I want to ask this to Tom, actually, because as a man that's done, you did like a life modelling thing once, didn't you?
With Liam Payne.
With Liam Payne.
Took all my clothes off.
Do you think that Stormzy has this?
Just in my Speedos.
Oh, nice.
I feel like you and Stormzy hosting a life drawing class together now. Do you see potential in him?
There's nothing I'm proud of down there. So.
Tom's just drawn on a little post-it note.
Yeah. There's absolutely... I mean, yeah. I'd love to do a live drawing class with you.
Oh, yeah, that would be great. Is that the kind of way you got to...
Pay me like one of your French girls.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what, though? Actually, think about this. You're very much in the art world now, and I'm going to ask you a question.
Okay.
You probably know who Banksy is.
Oh, he does.
I've heard this. A lot of people... Yeah.
Hold on, because you got the jacket for Glastonbury.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The stab proof vest. Yeah. The jacket. The Banksy jacket. That would have been epic, though. But yeah, no,
that was such a middle class take on what that was.
the Banksy jacket, indeed. Yeah. I may or may not know who, you know what I mean? I don't know.
When did this handover happen? Did the handover happen in person? Or was it couriers?
No, it happened at Glastow. I tried it on before Glastow at rehearsals, and then it got delivered to Glastow, and
there it was
bestowed upon me. Do you know how I explain it? It's like, you know when King Arthur or Lancelot or Sir Lancelot, one of the two.
Yeah.
You know when they pulled a sword out this stone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, that's what the Banksy vest felt like.
It
felt
like,
oh my gosh, I am the one.
It's time.
It's time. I am the one. I am the one who has been chosen.
And so there's a few things that I want to actually. One was the Banksy thing, which I think is so sick.
Thank
I saw the Glastonbury performance. I was there in the crowd having
much.
It.
Thank you.
Unreal.
Thank you.
And I want to ask you about the Jay-Z story as well, because I have to, seeing you're here.
Yeah,
seeing
yeah.
you're the only man ever to mug off Jay-Z completely.
No, it was never, do you know what?
Who wants Jay-Z on a track anyway?
No, do you know what it is? Do you know what? You can never mug off Jay-Z. And that's when the story broke and it was kind of like, oh, Stormzy, I was like, listen, no. You can't turn down the Jigga Man. Do you know what I mean? That's the legend. But no, he stopped the music. He kind of made the call when and he kind of put it to me like, what are we doing here? And I was just kind of like, Jay Man, I don't know.
So people that don't know the story, you were in the studio with Jay-Z and Ed Sheeran, doing Take Me Back to London, and Jay-Z was supposed to be on the track, it wasn't right in the room, or it's weird for him because he's not from London.
Yeah, so there's that, he's not from London, but also sonically, it was just like, I don't know, and but to be fair, like, we had this wicked powerful conversation in the studio, he stopped the music and was like, kind of like, let's just kind of chill out, let's talk. And then we had this wicked chat. And then after the chat, it's like he kind of realized, and we both kind of realized that, like, do you know what, wow, this is serious. This is a more important moment than maybe we both realized. And he was like, yeah, so what are we doing here? And I was like, yeah, I don't think we should do it. And he was kind of like,
I get it.
He kind of got it. Yeah. And then, yeah. But yeah, after that, I felt like I could do anything after that. I came straight back to London after. I was meant to stay in South Africa for a couple of days. But it was so epic. Like, it was the most, like, I was just talking to Jay-Z, it's deep. No, he's
next level.
Bro, he is, I always say there's no one I rate more on this planet than him, apart from my mum. My mum's probably the only person I rate. And my manager, I do rate Toby, my manager, he's a G.
Yeah.
But I was like, Jay-Z, like, there's no one on earth who I look at and think, bruv, that is, what a man, that. Like, so, he gave me a lot of motivation, and he let me know I have a lot of integrity, and what I did was like gutsy, and I was just so like shaken up by it. I gotta go home. I had bare energy, came back home and started recording again.
So amazing. Sick.
And Merry Christmas, by the way.
Merry Christmas, guys. Merry Christmas.
And we were talking about sort of weird presents that people have received, because you get rogue ones. Not everyone knows what you want, you know what I mean? Have you got any, have you ever received anything very off-brand and you've just kind of had to pretend that you liked it?
You know, I'm bad, you know. I always say, it's bad. It is bad. This is very bad. But I always say, like, not even in an ungrateful way, but I always say, like, just don't, I don't mind not getting presents.
Yeah.
Because I'm someone, it's bad.
You're fussy.
Yeah. Not that I'm fussy, but I'll judge the present.
As you're opening it.
You know when people say it's the thought that counts?
Yeah.
So I always say, let's just not do it. I don't mind getting people, I always get people presents, but. I'm cool to not get
them. I mean, the important question that I want to ask you is, your mum's the best, right? I feel like you can't give your mum a dressing gown.
No.
I feel like she likes the nicer things
in
life.
Definitely.
What are you getting her for Christmas? Because this is a big one.
I'm going to get her something really nice. I think I've got her something already, but I don't want to say it now because then the word will get back to her.
Okay. Has she put requests in? Does she give you a list?
No, she just lets it be known that I am a woman of luxury. So just...
She just whispers Chanel into your ear.
Yeah, she just whispers Chanel.
You know what we got. Kiss Breakfast with ID Mobile. Treat yourself this Christmas with great value deals from just £6 a month at idmobile.co.uk. The B of the UK. Kiss.